You got a shot? Donald can win this thing. Come on now. He don't even want to be president. You know he don't want to be president. He didn't thought he was going to get this far. He had no plan to get this far. He, they're like, you win it. He's like, what? And I don't want to be president. I'm just playing. Trying to make me some money. That's all. He ain't got, you can tell he wasn't trying to get this far because he ain't got no policy. Like, what's your foreign policy? Kill everybody and build a fence. That's all he got. And you know, once he get it, he go, now if Donald Trump get it, that open the floodgates. Now everybody be running for president. Diddy gonna be running for president. Diddy 2020. I told you that we won't stop. Lil Jon will run in 2024 like, yeah! Lil Jon, vote for me, baby! Yeah! You know, Al Sharpton gonna be mad. Al like, why couldn't get in? Actually, Al gonna have to realize the president can't have no perm. Wouldn't that be the president with no perm? We going to war, Al getting a relaxer. When he talked to the president, Al up under the dryer, he can't talk about it. We in the air conditioner, you got to stay up under there 20 minutes. Can't talk right now, I'm sorry, man. I told y'all I need some more dryers on Air Force One. You don't like that bag on the seat. Al showed up to the press conference, he got curly nine birds on his forehead. He messed around and get a weed for the inauguration, messed the whole press corps. Yeah, the president's hair grew overnight. Sources say it was a Yankee number 9. Back to you, Anderson. We live in an interesting time. Anytime Bruce Jenner talking about he want to be a woman, they want you to call him Caitlin. I said, I'm not calling you Caitlin, Bruce. I'm going to call you Bruce when I see you. Y'all smell that. What's up, Bruce? Bruce! What's up, bro? Bruce! What's up, baby? I noticed some of y'all got a little tight when I said that. See, it's changed now. Now people get scared when you mention homosexuality or gay marriage or something like that. See how y'all got tight in a minute, in about 10 years? If you mention homosexuality or gay marriage, you'll be like a runaway slave. Like, I don't agree with gay marriage. Shut your mouth! Don't you say that, mother people, they gonna get you! Run on down there, get on by the river! Spit it on, Lord! Go on down to Mickey, then get on the train and go up to New York City! They'll come looking for you on a horse night. Where are they? Where are they? Come out wherever you are. We see you. Send all your emails to pastor@linkupchurch.com. I'll tell you. That's my pastor. Pastor ain't said it, I said it.
Pastor, we need to appreciate that.
Some of y'all really laughing, some of y'all laughing. No. Come on, Lord, man. Woo! It's an interesting time, man.
Oh, God.
I'm telling you, boy. You know? And see, me, I've been married now 20 years. And when you've been married 20 years, your life. Yeah. That's how long you've been married, man. How long you 19 years. 18. Praise God. Y'all give him a round of applause. 18 years. Congratulations. Pastor said 19 for it. Let me straighten out real quick. 18. See, it's okay if you give an extra one. What you don't want to do is come in short. 17. 18. You've been married 20 years and certain stuff, I don't argue about. My white come in, a certain day, I learned to of the power of what I call a shepherd seed. Fellas, I've learned something, fellas. I've learned that your wife don't want you to talk every time she talk to you.
Oh, God.
Sometimes your wife just want to vent, and she don't want you to say nothing. I don't get into a lot of arguments with my wife because I try to fix her problems.
Right.
So she come to me and talk to me about something. I said, see, what you need to do is tell her, hold up, that's my family. I didn't ask you about that.
What you need to do.
Shut up sometimes. Sometimes they come in and talk to
you
to sit
there.
Man.
For real.
Oh, no. No audience, no problem. I learned to help out around the house. Helping out around the house helps you out a whole lot. Ooh, fellas, I'm telling you, ain't nothing like your wife come home and she been out with the kids or she been done went shopping or working. And you come home and she come home and she, you done cleaned up. Ooh, fellas.
Hey, I'm going to cut it back off. I got to switch my batteries. Give me a second, y'all.